Orcs fight each other endlessly to climb the hierarchy.
Then we shall find the ones who rise to the top. They are who we want in our army.
Mordor has no shortage of seasoned warriors.
From them, we will build our army.
The Overlord got annoyed at this glob and tore his head right off.
Guess two heads weren't enough for him.
Is overrun with orcs, perfect for our purpose.
What became of Lothariel? The people? Queen Marwyn, it was she who first suggested an orc army.
This time will be different. We have the new ring.
I've had enough of your mouth, Bruce. So now I'm gonna kill you, for all these orcs to see.
Always said you were an optimist. Know what that is, mate? It's about sizing up a situation that's bloody impossible and saying, yeah, all right, I'll have a go. I'm exactly the same way. I like him.
I know more about that elf assassin than anyone. I know
Come on, lads, get him! Yeah, come on then. Never can have too many heads.
Bruise.
Reckon you're going to skewer me? Ah, that little sword's good for a tickle, maybe. But you're going to need more than that to take me down.
Spines out, which I like to do anyway, so either way's a win.
A fine addition to our army.
Name's Bruce. From here on out, I will be your shadow. No one gets to you without my say-so.
Don't worry about my enemies. They will all follow eventually.
You want to plant your flag in Mordor, you'll need to do it deep. There's a fortress nearby. They say it's ruled by a two-headed troll big as a mountain. Deadly smart, which... because he'd have to be given the two heads. You take him down, you'll send a message to Sauron and get yourself some nice new digs as part of the bargain.
I'm not going to do this alone.
Gather your troops.
Will do. Ooh, just make sure you let me pop his heads off, won't ya?
Weakening enemy power is important. But what is most crucial for conquest is strengthening our own forces.
On your knees!
Grimwalker! How much salt would it take to make a whole ocean salty? I love it.
Kneel before me!
I believe this statue depicts Galadriel, an elf queen from a legendary forest beyond Gondor. I found scant reference to her in our books, but I know her name means Tree Maiden, and she's said to have hair of gold and silver. She was an elven monarch of the First Age. What wonders she must have seen when the world was so young.
Did you know Galadriel?
Know her. She is an aunt of sorts. Suffice it to say, we did not always see eye to eye.
Thank you.
Something just moved!
An intruder!
Oh, that cut deep!
Rally,
Submit!
You the meaning of the word savage.
They have their beasts now.
That won't be enough to stop me.
Thank you.
He's dumb!
Yeah!
was an island in the Sundering Seas to the west, the greatest realm of men before it sank beneath the waves. Few survived that calamity, mostly pioneers keen to settle what we now call Middle-earth. We Gondorians have often sought inspiration in what we know of Numenor, and many a young soldier would come to touch the brow of this helmet, wondering what great battles in far-off lands its owner must have seen.
Of Numenor. Adequate craftsmanship, given the materials available.
That is the closest you've come to respecting a fellow craftsman.
I'm telling you, I rode a drake. I really did!
How many times do I have to tell you this? It was a joke. With leather wings on it.
Someone here!
Is close. Watch for sentries.
Ah! Your suffering will be sweet delight!
What's that over
there? Traitorous Glob! Taste my blade!
Etragitha.
Thank you.
This ore comes from a longboat that washed ashore in the Bay of Belphalus, and it surely passed through many a corsair's hands before finding its way inland, where I espied it atop a merchant's cart years ago. I've often wondered about the hands that rowed it to sea. Were they the calloused hands of a slave, or those of a dashing corsair of Umbar? I suppose I'll never know.
What use has an oar away from its boat, and so far from the sea?
To remind people that Middle-earth exists beyond the bounds of Mordor.